May the Lord bless you today in the name of Jesus. Today I want to say, God is with you at all times, in every situation. God is with you in all times, in all situations. That unpleasant, life-changing experience that you face it might have been a shock to you. But God knew about that before He created you. And He already set up an internal encouragement system within you to assist you on those difficult times. When you will accept Jesus Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, despite the setbacks, detours, and pit stops that you face, remember that God has a purpose for you and will be fully fulfilled. God Almighty, in the name of Jesus, I ask you today, the Word of God, to guide us, to show us that you are with us. I will not be afraid. I can't be afraid. Name of Jesus. Psalms 23 verses 4. David, the King David, was facing something in his life. Something wrong. More than a dozen times, he faced death. King Saul and other enemies always come against David. He always was facing battles, wars, facing his enemies. And when you face a dangerous situation, when you face difficult times, you need to believe in Jesus. You need to believe in God. And then David said, verses 4, Psalm 23, even though I walk through the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. So David was facing shadow of death, the valley of shadow of death. He was facing a death trap situation. When you face things like that, when you face the dangers of a sickness, a disease, a death is around. You face situations that your family is at risk, your marriage is at risk, your happiness is at risk. What you gonna do? You're gonna get desperate? You're gonna start to cry? You're gonna start to yelling? This is what everybody do. People, they get desperate. But David, he said, in the valley of shadow of death, he said, I will fear no evil. I will fear nothing, because you are with me. So to say that, you need to be strong in your faith. You need to be walking in your faith. You need to have a strong believing in God. Everyone is affected in distresses, but God, He comes to end timely encouragement. Remember David. David, he had a relationship with God. David, he was a God worshiper, a servant of God, a man of God's own heart. So, in the midst of this the distress in the midst of this facing of threat of death, he said, I will fear no evil. I was reading 1 Samuel chapter 30. Said that David, he took his men to the battlefield, and he left behind on the camping, he left the spouse, the women's, the children's, and the elderless. And David was over there on the battlefield fighting the enemy through the battle. The enemies, they get behind of David's compound, and they took the women's. They burned down all the house. They took the riches and the kids. They just left the elderly behind. So when David returned from the battlefield, he found the compound burned down to the ground. The women's was took. The children's, they take. They take the riches. So everybody started to cry out. There was a desperation. They took our families. They took our wives. They took our kids. They took our money. And then in the midst of this situation, somebody else said, let's go. Let's go stone David. They took stones, rocks in their hands, and they tried to kill David. So his own men, his fellow soldiers, want to kill him because they blame David. You know, when something go wrong in your house, in your family, always someone is trying to blame somebody else. No, it's their fault. Let's go stone him. 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 6 said David was greatly distressed because the men were taking of stoning him. So a lot of men, his own friends, tried to stone him to death, which one was bitter in spirit because of his sons and daughters. But David found strength in the Lord his God. So that David didn't pay attention. You cannot pay attention. You know, every time when you face something, a storm, a turmoil, you're in the middle of the fight, you're in the middle of a battlefield, you face a strong resistance, someone comes from nowhere and you start to attack you. You start to gossiping about you. You start to say things, bad things about you. This is a trap. This is a devil trap that the devil is sending that person to create a diversion. Yeah, because you start to pay attention to the gossip, you start to pay attention to what they're saying about you, and you go there and you start to argue with them, you start to fight with them, and your problem is still not resolved. You face a sickness, you face a wedding, a marriage problem, a family problem. You have no time to waste with those kind of stuff. So David, he didn't pay attention to this. He goes and he found a strength in the Lord. If you go continually reading chapter 30 of 1 Samuel, verses 7 and 8, says that David, he goes and he consults the Lord. He talked to God. He goes to God and he asking God, God, what I have to do? Do I have to go after those people and take and fight them and recover our wives, the daughters, the sons, and the riches? And then David, he listened to the voice of God. God told you that go, David, go after your enemies. Fight them back. I will fulfill my promises in you. You're going to recover everything that you have lost. And David, he listened to the word of God, and he put together a small army, and he go after the Amalekites, and he fight back, and he recovered everything that he had lost. He recovered the wives, the daughters, the kids, the riches. See, we need to fight. You need to keep fighting. Whoever contradictory the situation is that is involving us, God has never forsaken us. Even in tough times, He has given to us reason to believe, to continue following Him. Psalms 9:10 says, "For you, Lord, have never forsaken us, those who seek in you." After David encouraged himself in God, he believed he was able to inquire in God's directions because he had faith and witnessed God's provisions, protections, and promises performed in the past. He knew without doubt that God will come true for him. Psalms 27:14 said, "Waiting with patience for the Lord, and be strong and courageous." Psalm 21:24 said, "Be strong and courageous, all of you who hope in the Lord." Oh Lord, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this word. I want to ask you, O Lord, to bless those who listen to this sermon. Those who are facing troubles, storms, battles. Those who are facing difficult times. I want to ask you to come and teach them, show to them, to don't be afraid of no evil. We need to learn to say, "I will not be afraid of no evil, because God is with me. God is with us." If we trust in you, if you trust in your words and your promise, you're going to give us a strength to recover everything that we have lost. We're going to recover the promises in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.